Praise be! You have silenced the Shriekers and cleared our way. Yet it seems I'm in need of you again, my friend. You have any more miracles in you? We've got a boat ready to row to the Lady Vengeance. But if Alexander sees us bobbing among the waves, we'll be shark chow. So we split up. I take the Seekers to the Lady Vengeance. You go to the ruins and keep Alexander busy. He'll be expecting a breeze. Show him that you're a hurricane. Are you ready? We've got Wright on our side, a greater ally than any sulking Geist or any whinging Magister.
He takes the news calmly. A moment passes as he calculates the consequences, assessing this new world as it opens up before him. He nods his thanks, then raises his voice.
Seekers, we move. You are Lucian's eyes and ears. You are his sword and his shield. Burn the blackness with your holy fire!
I see flurries and the air thrums. Could it be slain? Look! Look at him! He has come, true to his word.
We'll have to deal with them.
There you are. The escapee. I feared you'd made it to Reaper's Coast by now. Anyway, you're here now. You know, Dallas and Friedemann warned me about you, Godwoken. I'm afraid your journey ends here. You would only bring ruin to Rivellon. If anyone is going to become the next Divine, it will be me. I have no illusions that history will look kindly upon me. My only goal is to guarantee that someone should survive to write such histories. I'm one of you, after all. Your collar is no tighter than my own. I can bear anything for the sake of the realm. It was the most important lesson my father taught me. Be strong. Not because you are. Be strong because you must. For them. For the realm. For your loved ones. For the children you'll never have. Please, don't make this harder than it has to be. It's not your fault, but still you stand in the way of peace. This must be... You stand no chance, but I admire your resilience. Give it your best shot.
cornered. Glory is mine. Show yourself. Thank you.
I'm ready.
Thank you.
Sorcering will be the death of us all.
Alexander is dead. My contract
Alexander
is fulfilled.
Alexander has fallen. The son of Lucian is dead. Murderers!
Well, well, quite the mess you've made here. I'm Malady, and you're...
She steps forward, grabs you behind the neck with alarming strength, and pulls you close. She sniffs twice, her nose at your ear, then bites, piercing the lobe with a needle-sharp fang. She releases you and grins, running tongue over teeth.
God-woken. I can tell a lot from a little taste. The carnage on this beach nearly speaks for itself, but... still, one can't be too careful.
She leans back, looks you over, and smirks.
So, Godwoken, you're what gets some of us out of bed each morning. What do you make of that? Well, first things first. Dallas's little necklaces are lovely, but not quite in vogue where we're going. They're better.
She peers at you closely, a knowing squint in her eye.
Tell me, which of those little gods did you meet, and what did they teach you?
Her eyes go wide.
Go on then. Show me what he taught you. Hey, that stings.
She examines her hands, where the skin sizzles slightly beneath their newfound aura. As the spell fades, the skin heals once more. Her whole body seems to relax.
You really are Godwoken. I'm happy. Oh, how unbecoming. Come then, we set sail, your destiny awaits, etc. You'll have to ask the Meister about that. She's dying to meet you.
Malady beckons you to the boat.
After you, darling. Boat first, questions later. As you wish. Thank you.